In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to change the desktop wallpaper when your Windows 10 or Windows 11 isn't activated. As you can see, such copies of the OS have a desktop watermark and the personalization settings aren't available apart from the option to change the theme from here, in Windows 11 only, I believe. Here's a workaround, which is available in File Explorer. If you have the wallpaper image file, which you probably do, right-click on it and choose Set as Desktop Background. On Windows 11, you can also use the ribbon. Another way to change the background, which also enables you to set it as a lock screen picture, is included with the Photos app. Open the picture and right-click, then choose Set as Lock Screen or Background, as you can see. But some images don't fit your desktop well. Not using the Settings app means you can't choose whether an image is styled, stretched, or fills your desktop. Trust me, I only recently found out that the Paint app actually allows you to set such options for the image. Simply choose to open with Paint, in the File menu expand Set as Desktop Background, and choose Fill, Tile, or Center. You can see the difference, Tile or Fill. Now, what if you want a slideshow? Well, you certainly won't use the Settings app, will you? The solution is, again, File Explorer. Just select multiple images, choose to set them as desktop background, and you have a slideshow. Keep watching and you'll see how to change the duration, hopefully. This involves using an old control panel page, inaccessible from the control panel itself, and only available if you type in one special command in the run box, well known from earlier versions of Windows. I will include the contents of this text file in the video description below. Now, as you can see, this is the personalization page from Windows 7, which is still included with Windows 11 and allows you to tweak various settings related to desktop personalization. You can even shuffle the pictures if you want. There are also additional settings related to the picture position. I only hope this page is still included when you're watching this tutorial. Here are two more ways to customize the Windows desktop if you're a computer enthusiast. But first, here's the old theme picker in case Windows doesn't allow you to change the theme. Open the ROM box and remove the slash page wallpaper thing and also make sure to do it right. As you can see, here you can select Windows dark theme and others. It is a little bit buggy sometimes. It doesn't like the new File Explorer ribbon. Now, let's explore the depths of the legacy Windows applets and design even more using the command line. Let's open the long-forgotten Microsoft Internet Explorer. Yes, I am on Windows 11, and yes, Microsoft lied to you. The code is not important here. I have a few videos on the subject. Check them out. And subscribe if you haven't. The venerable Internet Explorer allows you to select any online image, provided, of course, that it can actually open the site, because it doesn't really support the new websites. Right-click on the image, for example the Google logo, and choose to set as background. This will change your desktop wallpaper, as you can see. For Pro, Education, and Enterprise versions of Windows, you can also use Force to change the wallpaper. The Group Policy Editor allows you to change the wallpaper once you navigate to User Configuration, Administrative Templates, Desktop, Desktop. Choose the Policy Desktop Wallpaper. It is usually used in organizations which want to force the company logo on screen and prevent users from changing that. Here's how it works. Enable the policy and then specify the full path to the image you want to use. This also allows you to adjust the picture position. Apply and see your desktop. Well, you might need to restart Explorer. Open the Task Manager and scroll down to Windows Explorer. Then, right-click and choose to restart the task. Wait a few moments and, as you will see, the desktop wallpaper has been changed. Thanks for watching, I hope this video was helpful and interesting. Please, don't forget to subscribe.